Hello dear students, in last class we already discussed about the resistance. So resistance means opposition offered to a flow of charges in a conductor. So that's what we consider that a resistance. Okay, so this resistance is inversely proportional to the electric current. It means whenever the amount of resistance increases, it means electric current decreases. When resistance value increases, when a temperature increases, atomically resistance increases. When a length of a conductor increases, atomically resistance increases. When area of a cross section of a conductor increases, so resistance value decreases. And this resistance is also depends upon a material of a conductor. It is a different conductor having a different resistance value. So this reason you already know that Ohm's law. Electric current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference across the two ends of a conductor. So here temperature and other conditions remains constant. So that's what we consider that Ohm's law. So this reason here, so resistance R is equal to V divided by I. It means, so this resistance is always inversely proportional to the electric current. And here, so this resistance depends upon length of a conductor, and the resistance also depends upon area of a cross section of a conductor. So this resistance is directly proportional to the length of a conductor and inversely proportional to area of a cross section of a conductor. Whenever area of a cross section of a conductor increases, then the resistance value decreases. Whenever length of a conductor increases, then the resistance increases. Okay, so this reason, so resistance is equal to, we want one proportionality constant. So that's why we consider that a rho. So rho into L divided by A. It means R is equal to rho into L divided by A. Rho we consider that a proportional constant. It means a resistance constant. It is nothing but a resistivity. Rho. Resistivity. Okay, so resistivity. Okay, so this reason, the resistivity, it means R into A divided by L, R into A divided by L. So this reason, here we want to calculate, so this resistivity value, it means resistivity value means, so we want to know the SI unit of resistivity. So SI unit of resistivity, you already know that SI unit of resistance is ohm. SI unit of resistance. So SI unit of resistance is ohm, and area of a cross section. So area is a meter square, and the length L is equal to meter. So this reason, so resistivity rho is equal to resistance ohm, area meter square, and length meter. Okay, so meter square get cancelled. So this reason, resistivity SI unit of resistivity is S ohm meter. Ohm meter. Okay, SI unit of this resistivity is ohm meter. Okay, so this resistivity, it means, suppose here we consider that, so this one is a conductor. Okay, it's having a particular area of a cross section and it's having a particular length. So this reason, suppose if we consider that unit area of a cross section and unit length of a conductor. It means particular area of a cross section and particular one unit of a length. How much resistance is present in that unit cross sectional area and unit length? So that's what we consider that resistivity. Suppose one unit of a length is there, and here we consider that cross sectional area is also one unit. It is a particular area of a cross section. It is a how much a resistance is present in that area of a cross section of a conductor and a unit length of a conductor. So that's why we consider that a resistivity. Generally, alloys or metal, the resistivity value, we consider that 10 power minus 8 to 10 power minus 6. It means 10 power 8 to 10 power. It means 10 power minus 8 to 10 power minus 6 means a very less amount of resistivity. Suppose if you consider that a rubber or non-metals or insulators, we consider that a resistance value. So 10 power 10 to up to 10 power 12. It means a maximum resistivity value. Suppose if you consider that metal, it is a conductor, it's a resistance, resistivity 10 power minus 8 ohm meter to 10 power minus 6 ohm meter. Suppose if you consider that non-conductors or insulators, it's a resistivity value 10 power 10 to 10 power 12 ohm meter. It means this one is a maximum value. Yes, next one. So these resistors are connected in a series or parallel. It means a combination of a resistance. Okay, in combination of a resistance, suppose we want a maximum amount of a resistance value. It means we have some number of a resistance. Yes, by using this resistance, we just increase the resistance value. Or same amount of resistance we have, by using this resistance, we can decrease the resistance value. For example, here we consider that three resistance are there. I have three resistance. Okay, so first resistance. So this one we consider that R1. And the second resistance. So this one we consider that R2. Another one resistance. So this one we consider that R3. Okay, we have three resistance. By using three resistance, we can increase the resistance value, or sometimes we can decrease the resistance value. Okay, so resistance. So this one, for example, 10 ohm, 10 ohm, 10 ohm. It means all three having the same resistance value. How to increase the total resistance value? How to decrease the total resistance value? It depends upon the combination. So here we consider that the two types of combination. One is series combination, another one is a parallel combination. One is series combination, another one is a parallel combination. In a series combination, so series of combination means one resistance is connected with another resistance and this resistance connected with another one resistance. Okay, one end of resistance connected with another end of resistance. And this end of resistance connected with another end of resistance. It means end to end connection we consider that a series. Series resistance or a series combination of a resistance. So series combination. Okay, series combination, so number of resistors are connected end to end. Okay, so here three resistors, so this one is the first resistance connected with another resistance and this resistance connected with another one resistance. Okay, so this one is R1 and R2 and R3. Okay, so three resistors are connected to end. So this one we consider that a series combination. Okay, so here in this series combination, we will get a maximum number of a resistance value. Okay, so this reason, so this one R1, R2 and R2, so these three resistors are connected with the end to end. Okay, and these resistors are connected to a battery. Series battery. And here we consider that so current. Suppose here we consider that 1 ammeter, okay, so positive and negative. So resistance, we don't consider that positive and negative, only we consider that ends. And here we connected 1 voltmeter. Yes, so this one is one voltmeter. Okay, so here we want to calculate equivalent resistance value. Okay, equivalent resistance value means a total value of a resistance. So that's why we consider that the equivalent resistance value. Yes, so this means that here three resistances are connected in the series. How much resistance we will get? So that's why we consider that the equivalent resistance value. Okay, so in this combination, the potential difference or potential difference is different for each resistance. Why? Because we already know that formula R is equal to V divided by I. R is equal to V divided by I. V means a potential difference, I means electric current, and R we consider that a resistance. Okay, so this reason, each resistance having a different potential difference. So this reason, I will consider that, so this is circuit. So first resistance having a one particular potential difference. Okay, so this one we consider that a V1. And a second resistance, and here we consider that another one, a voltmeter. So positive and negative. Okay, so this one we consider that a V2. Another one resistance. So here we connected another one voltmeter. So positive and negative. So this one we consider that a V3. Okay, and here the electric current flowing throughout the circuit remains the same. In a series combination, electric current remains the same, but potential difference changes for a different resistance. It means potential difference value changes, but electric current remains the same. Potential difference value changes. Okay, so this reason, we already know that formula R is equal to V divided by I. So this reason, here the potential difference value changes. The potential difference value changes, it means, so first one, so first potential difference V1 is equal to, the resistance is R1 and electric current we consider that I. Okay, so potential difference V is equal to I into R. So this reason, here we consider that first resistance potential difference V1 is equal to I. It means electric current throughout the circuit remains the same, R into resistance value R1. And the second one, V2. It means electric current remains the same, but potential difference V2 is there, so this reason resistance R2. And here V3 is equal to I into R3. So V1 is equal to I into R1, V2 is equal to I into R2, V3 is equal to I into R3. So we want to calculate equivalent resistance value. So this reason, the equivalent resistance, here we consider that, so this one is equivalent resistance value, and we consider that a potential difference, I is electric current. Okay, equivalent resistance, it means, so here we consider that the first is a V, we consider that a total potential difference, R we consider that the equivalent resistance value. So this reason, here we consider that R into R, yes, RS means a number of resistance are connected in the series. So this reason, our formula V is equal to I into RS. It means the number of resistance are connected in a series. Okay. So this reason, in the place of V, it means total potential difference. So total potential difference, it means V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay, so we consider that equivalent potential difference. So this is an equivalent potential difference is I into RS. Okay, I into Rs is equal to V1. V1 value. I into R1 plus V2 value. I into R2 plus V3 value. I into R3. Okay, so IRS we consider that a equivalent to potential difference. So this is a IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. Okay, so here the common factor we consider that electric current in series combination, electric current remains a constant, it is remains the same. So this is an I into RS is equal to common factor we consider that electric current I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay, so this reason I get cancelled with this RS. So number of resistors are connected in series. RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So number of resistors are connected in the series is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay, so this RS we consider that the equivalent resistance. So this equivalent resistance is nothing but the sum of individual resistance present in the circuit. So equivalent resistance is nothing but sum of individual resistance present in this circuit. So this one we consider that equivalent resistance value. Okay, whenever the number of resistance increases, okay, equivalent resistance value is also increases. For example, here we consider that first resistance is 10 ohm, and this one is also we consider that 10 ohm. So this reason R1, R2, R3. So 10 ohm plus 10 ohm plus 10 ohm. It means the total RS, it means equivalent resistance value we consider that 30 ohm. Yes, okay. So this reason, whenever the number of resistance increases, it means, so this equivalent resistance value is also increases. Yes, equivalent resistance means it is the sum of individual resistance present in the circuit. So this reason, whenever the number of resistance increases in a series, then equivalent resistance is also increases. Suppose we have some resistance. How to increase the total resistance value? It means whenever, so these resistance are connected end to end. Then what happens? Equivalent resistance increases. If we increase the resistance value, we can connect these resistance end to end or in a series combination. Then only equivalent resistance value increases. Suppose, so these resistance are connected parallel. Resistance are connected in parallel, then what happens? Equivalent resistance value decreases. So this reason, when resistance are connected in a series, equivalent resistance value increases. So this reason, the formula of a series combination, so here we consider that RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Suppose if we consider that the number of resistance are there. So number of resistance, it means n number of resistance. So this reason, so formula we consider that RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus so on we consider that Rn. It means n number of resistance are there. Those are connected in series. Then a formula RS is equal to. Then formula here we consider that RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So on we consider that Rn. So this is a formula of a number of resistance are connected in a series. Number of resistance is nothing but n number of resistance are connected in a series. Okay. So RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay. So this circuit we consider that a circuit diagram. of a series combination. So here only three resistors are there. Suppose if you consider that the two resistors are connected in the series, it means Rs is equal to R1 plus R2, only two resistors. Suppose the n number, R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4, up to we consider that the n number of a resistance. Okay, so this is going to be considered that a series combination of a resistance. So in series combination of a resistance, so potential difference value changes, but electric current remains the same. Electric current value remains the same, but a potential difference value changes. Sometimes, so this ammeter I will connect here, so positive and the negative. S I will connect here,